Let's talk about another disaster, entitlements. Nothing in this budget touches entitlement reform, which anyone who can add knows is a long-term problem that has to be addressed. However, in your party, you've got Elizabeth Warren and Third Way on opposite ends of this battle. Are you worried that entitlement reform over the next year or two or three is going to drive a wedge in your party?
A little. But it's not nearly the same. Put it this way. Am I concerned that, like, when I spend Christmas with my Republican brother, you'd love my brother, total Republican, that we'll have a debate over dinner? Well, we will, of course. But the Republicans are having the Battle of Antietam with thousands of people slaughtering each other in the fields. It's not the same.
There is a bit of a debate on my side, but there's a civil war on Tim's side.
That's grossly exaggerated.
You're just bragging about how you go run ads against Republicans.
You're not worried.
I've been talking about the fact we hold both sides accountable. That's totally different. Look at what the left has been doing when you talk about food stamps. We're going to get food stamp reform. That's going to happen next year. We're going to see that happen. It needs to happen.
Can I just, on behalf of George Orwell, ask you all to say cuts when you mean cuts and not say reform? You don't want to reform. You want to take away food stamps from homeless veterans who fought for their country. Well, you should describe it that way, Tim, because that's what you're doing, man.
There are $80 billion a year being spent on food stamps for 50 million Americans. The same people running that program are the ones who brought us the Obamacare rollout. The same people. All we're saying is let's reform
it's
it.
Inefficient.
Let's find a way to save 5 cents on the dollar.
But
that's
back
it,
to
five
this.
Cents
I,
on the
I,
dollar.
I like,
and so
like,
if you want to roll out individual horror stories, we're going to provide a safety net. But to say that you can't find 5 cents on the dollar in savings out of a program that big and that bloated and by the same people who have destroyed the idea of Obamacare in the first 2 or 3 months of a rollout, I don't think Americans are going to buy that, Paul.
While protecting corporate welfare in that farm
bill. I want to get rid of corporate welfare. Let's do it. Let's kill it. Let's get rid of it. We've run ads on that, too, in Republican districts. Paul, here's one for you. We've run ads in Iowa and Nebraska in Republican districts saying get rid of the corporate welfare. Because if you're going to get rid of social welfare programs, or at least trim them back and reform them, you've got to get rid of the corporate welfare. And we believe in that and support that.
Any of the corporate welfare that, like, say, pick a random company, Coke Industries gets?
Absolutely. We have called repeatedly for getting rid of the ethanol subsidy.
We want to get rid of the ethanol.
Oil subsidy. We want to get
rid of the oil subsidy. How about those energy subsidies, oil company subsidies, for example?
Yes. There's a reason Big Oil doesn't support us. By the way, if you're watching Big Oil, you're welcome to support us, okay? But they're not, because we want to get rid of all the subsidies across the board.
That's an honorable position.
We want a level playing field, and that includes ag subsidies.
Can we work with you?